Hello everyone, welcome back to the Chemical Engineering channel. And as you know that from the previous lecture, we have shifted our focus from heat transfer operations to the mass balance. And in this regard, we are bringing the lecture number 2 on the mass balance. So if you have not subscribed yet, please do subscribe the channel, click the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. So again, we will start from the point that we will first read the concept of mass balance, and then we will be solving some numericals related to mass balance. So the concept is that total balance is equal to mass in should be equal to mass out, and the component balance is that the component fraction associated with the mass in should be equal to the component fraction associated with the mass out. So that is the law of conservation of mass which is applied over here. So numerical number 1 is that how many kg per hour of sugar syrup with 10% sugar must be fed to an evaporator to produce 10,000 kg per hour of sugar syrup with 65% sugar. Now case is a bit different. In our previous numericals we knew the feed and we had computed the value of product, but in this case we have been given that the production is 10,000 kg per hour of sugar syrup whose concentration is 65%, and we have to compute that how much kg per hour of sugar syrup with 10% sugar must be fed to an evaporator to produce this phenomena. So if we look at this diagram, that this x which is 10% concentrated, obviously water will be evaporated from this system and product will be formed. Now we know this value, which is the flow rate of the product. Earlier we knew this value, so now it's a reverse process. So we know that x is equal to w plus, if we say p, that w plus p, and accordingly we will be applying the component balance. So let's apply the balance over here. So the overall balance is that x is equal to w plus 10,000. This 10,000 is known, which is the final product. This W is the water evaporated and this X is the feed in the system. So soluble solids mass balance 0.1 multiplied by X, 10% which is in the feed, 65% which is with the product. W does not contain any soluble solid mass, and accordingly X is calculated from this equation as 65,000 kg per hour, while the water evaporated is 55,000 kg per hour. So we can say that 65,000 kg per hour of the feed is introduced to the evaporator, 55,000 of which is evaporated, while the 10% of which is our final product, which contains 65% sugar. So accordingly, 65,000 kg per hour of sugar syrup with 10% sugar must be fed to an evaporator to produce 10,000 kg per hour of sugar syrup with 65% sugar. So that is how, even if you are given the product, you can go reverse and find out the value of the feed stream. Now moving on to the second numerical. How much water must be added to 200 kg of concentrated orange juice with 65% solids to produce orange juice with 12% solids? So we have to calculate the value of water which needs to be added to a feed whose mass is 200 kg, whose concentration is 65%, and final product is 12% solids. So if we look at this, that this is a mixing system. We know the value of the feed, which is 200 kg. 65% concentration, the water is added, which is W, the final product, which is J, it is 12% concentrated. We do not know the value of J, we do not know the value of W. But again, the process is very simple. What we need to do, again, in the same way, apply the total balance, and overall mass balance is equal to 200 plus W is equal to J. And accordingly, after overall balance, we will be applying the soluble solid mass balance, which is associated with this one, which is the feed and the product, but not with the water. So 200 multiplied by 65%, 12% multiplied by this product. So we get the value of J is equal to 1083.33 kg per hour, and accordingly we need W is equal to 883.33 kg per hour. So we can say that 883.33 kg per hour of water must be added to 200 kg of concentrated orange juice with 65% solids to produce orange juice with 12% solid. So that is the overall, again, two cases we have discussed, the flow rate of product, and accordingly we have applied reverse balance and computed the feed. And in this case we knew one of the feed, we have computed firstly product and then we have computed the feed and the process as well. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more videos.